Do not miss out on the incredible deals at store.rebeloper.com/Black Friday. This Black Friday, enjoy a 50% discount on all products, including the popular Swift UI Camp. Elevate your development toolkit and make significant savings. Act fast, as this limited time offer is your ticket to unlocking top-notch resources at unbeatable prices. Sale ends this weekend. Visit store.rebeloper.com/Black Friday and seize the opportunity to supercharge your development journey while saving big. So I posted this tweet the other day about how I added AI into Xcode, and it got a lot of engagement. So I said to myself, this needs a YouTube video. And here we are. We are going to add AI into Xcode, and we are going to do it for free. Now, what do we talk about adding AI into Xcode? Well, it's code completion, helping you with code, writing it faster. Therefore, one that comes to mind is GitHub's Copilot. But GitHub's Copilot, of course, it's just $10 per month, and the first month is for free, but still, it's $10 per month. So how can you add this for free? And as you can see, this is, we have this nice GIF right over here. This is what we are going to build up. Now, what you want to do is just go for Codeium.com. This is my secret superpower for adding AI into Xcode. Of course, you want to create an account here, and then just go to get Codeium. And you can see you have Visual Studio Code and all of that. But we are looking for Xcode. And by the way, GitHub Copilot doesn't have an Xcode extension or integration. Codeium does. And this is a third-party library. By the way, GitHub Copilot also has a free extension on GitHub by the same developer that we are going to take a look at today. So let's just click over here so we can go to the repo. And yeah, as you can see, this is Codeium for Xcode. Let's just scroll down and install it right away. So I'm just going to go through this with you together. So first of all, we want to take a look at the releases and then download the zip file, which is the actual app. And once it's downloaded, you want to drag and drop it into your applications folder. So let me just do this real quick. While it's still downloading, let me just wait for that. And here we go. We have that available, and just drag and drop it right over here. As you can see, it's Codeium for Xcode. Let's move forward, and well, I will just go back over here to the README. And next up, we want to enable the extension, because actually this is an extension on Xcode. Now, go to the System Settings app. So just go and open up System Settings right over here. And what we want to do is just go into Privacy and Security Extensions and then enable Xcode. I know this is just Copilot. The README is outdated. Actually, this is a fork on Copilot for Xcode. So disregard when it says Copilot. Just know that it is Codeium for Xcode. So let's just go for Privacy and Security, and then just scroll all the way down, and you will see that we have these extensions right over here. And then you want to, well, actually you want to open up Xcode for this first, because we don't have, as you can see, our source editor just yet. So let's just open up Xcode right over here, and let's create a new Xcode project. It will be an iOS app, for example. Let's have this, and let's click on next right over here. Let's drop it onto the desktop. Doesn't really matter. Let's create that. And yeah, I can just replace that. Why not?
Unlock the power of seamless coding with this tutorial on integrating AI code completion into Xcode for free. Elevate your development workflow by harnessing the efficiency of artificial intelligence. My step-by-step guide walks you through the process, providing insights and practical tips to enhance your coding experience. Say goodbye to tedious typing and hello to smarter, faster coding. Access this valuable resource at no cost and revolutionize your Xcode environment effortlessly. Dive into the future of coding with this free AI code completion tutorial today.
So let's take a look at what else do we have to do. So grant permissions on the app. Maybe that's the first thing that we have to do, and then we can just go back to the source code editor. So what you want to do is go ahead inside your settings, system settings, go to privacy and security, and then scroll all the way down to accessibility. Because, you know, this is an extension, but it also needs to kind of read your file. It is going to do this on the file structure also. So then just drag and drop Codeium for Xcode onto the list. There we go. Let's use that password. That's it. Now let's take a look at privacy and security, and then accessibility. As you can see, now we have Codeium for Xcode enabled. Let's go back to our readme right over here. And then you want to, of course, Copilot for Xcode extension service. Let's launch this first, and then we are going to have this Codeium for extension, for Xcode extension service. So let's go to Codeium for Xcode. Let's launch this. Let's open this up. Make sure that you check automatically. Okay, so it says accessibility permissions not granted. First of all, let's go to extension settings. Let's click on that. And now you can see that we have this Xcode source code editor. And then we can check that. Let's click on done right over here. And now if we come back over here and let's check accessibility settings. And Codeium for Xcode is set up. Next up, we want to actually, let's just see what else do we want we want to log in. Yes, let's just go and check service and let's just install that. Okay, I'm already signed in, but let's just sign out and then sign in again so you can see how that looks like. Okay, and you are going to get this token, which you can copy and then just paste it in there, and then let's just sign in. Okay, and let's just take a look at the features. That's great, advanced, basically that's it. You can check for updates right over here. And now let's take a look at Xcode. So we're going to Xcode right over here. Okay, now we want to add the accessibility, because as you can see right over here, accessibility permission not granted. So let's review the extension service in Finder, and then we want to drag and drop this into our settings under, let's just go into accessibility settings. So it's under privacy and security and accessibility. So now what we want to do is just drag and drop this. Let me just grab it and drop it right over there. And of course, it has to be granted. Now, let's close and open Xcode one more time. Let's just see this and quit and launch this again. So we want to make sure that Codeium for Xcode and that extension is enabled. Okay, and now we are ready. As you can see, maybe you did notice there is this dot right over here. This controls Codeium for Xcode. Let's just get rid of the canvas too. And it's right over here. And if you just click on it, you will see that we can enable suggestions for Swift or disable it. And we can have real-time suggestions, hide common preceding spaces in suggestions. So that's automatically added. Let's just see, you can disable this or enable it. Usually it's just enabled. I just had a play around with it and disabled it on some files. That's why it was disabled. So now, as you can see, let's take a look at Twitter. So it says hello feed, and then I just added a new space and it was suggesting some code. So let's do this right now. And hopefully this will actually work from the first go, because, you know, it gets to warm up a little bit. So let's see if here we go. We have a new space. Well, it's not adding anything. Let's just have a dot and let's see. There we go. It is suggesting us the foreground color dot primary. Let's just accept that. That's fine. And then add a new line. As you can see, it's just suggesting a font dot system title design around it. Let's assume that this is also great. Now let's accept this. One final thing that you could do, not just click on all of these buttons from the suggestion, is just to set up key bindings. And let's just go right over here, set up key bindings. You want to go to the Xcode settings, key bindings. So let's open up Xcode again and then go to settings. And here you just want to select key bindings, and under the filter, just go for Codeium. And you will have all of the commands Codeium has. You will not have all of these set up by default. Just pick and choose whichever, or if not all, and you want to add them. There's a good list on the README what you actually want to choose, because those are do not have any conflict with other keyboard shortcuts. So go ahead and add all of these. Now, this is how easy it is to add AI code suggestions into your Xcode project for free. Now, if you did like this video, make sure to check out the Black Friday sale. And of course, make sure to check out my previous video, which was about how you can land an iOS job without a CS degree. Check it out. It's right over here.